Hello friends, I am CS Divya Bajpayee from CS Notes Own, author of the book Tax Laws and Practice. I am giving you a brief concept of GST, what is the need of the GST and its background. These concepts contain important dates which are very important for your examinations, because in upcoming examinations multiple choice questions is there, so dates are very important. Institute will confuse you by giving a nearby date, so recall it carefully and see the next slide. I would like to start with background of the GST. In background, I would like to start with the name of the country which was the first country to implement GST. France was the first country to implement GST in the year 1954. The Kelker task force recommended the fully integrated GST on national basis in which year, friends? In year 2004. Coming to the next point, the Constitution 122nd Amendment Bill 2014 on GST table on the Parliament on which date, friends? 19 December 2014. And this bill is passed in lower house Lok Sabha on 6th May 2015. Friends, I mark the dates red, just read it carefully, it is very important for your examinations. The bill on GST passed by upper house Raj Sabha on which date, friends? 3rd August 2016. The bill get the president assent and become the act on which date? On 8th September 2016. Now the central GST legislation. This central GST legislation contains four bills in totality. The central GST legislation contain four bills. What are that? See on the screen. Central Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, Integrated Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, Union Territory Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, and Goods and Services Tax Compensation to State Bills 2017. All these four bills in together is known as what? Central GST legislation. And all four bills were introduced in Lok Sabha on which date, friend? 27th March 2017. Passed in lower house on 29 March 2017, received president assent on 12 April 2017. After the enactment of the Central Act, state GST laws is also enacted by each state one by one. Okay, now I would like to summarize all the dates which are very important for your examinations. Okay friends, if you recall the last two slides, then you can answer. Now repeat, revise. The Constitution 122nd Amendment Bill 2017. Ye bill kis din parliament mein tabled hua tha? Date friends, on 19 December 2014. Kab ye lower house mein pass hua? On 6th May 2015. Kab ye upper house mein pass hua tha? On 3rd August 2016. President ki assent kab kis din mili thi jab ye act ban gaya tha? 8th September 2016. Coming to the next point, which is kya kya cheezein aati hain central GST legislations mein? Four bills थे, कौन कौन से? याद है नाम? याद करिए. Central Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, Integrated Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, Union Territory Goods and Services Tax Bill 2017, and Goods and Services Compensation to States Bill 2017. All these bills were introduced in Lok Sabha on which date, friends? 27 March 2017. Passed in Lok Sabha on 29 March 2017. These dates are very important. Please remember. President assent कब मिली थी इन चारों bills को, which जो central GST legislations हैं, कब मिली थी? 12th April 2017. Now the question arises, what is the need for GST? कोई भी नई system, कोई भी नई चीज तब आती है जब पुराने system में कुछ कमियां होती हैं. तो due to following deficiency in the earlier tax, indirect tax regime, what are that deficiency? Double taxation of a transaction at as both goods and services. कुछ transaction ऐसे होते थे जो हम as a good और as a service both consider कर लेते थे. उसमें या तो excise भी लग जाता था, service tax भी लग जाता था, VAT भी लगता था, service tax भी लगता था. तो यहाँ पर ऐसा नहीं है, यहाँ पे goods and services एक ही ambit में है. GST के अंदर पहले services पे अलग tax लगता था, that is service tax, and goods पे अलग tax लगता था, excise या फिर VAT. So now it is combined. Next point, non-integration of VAT and service tax. VAT में जो input tax credit था, वो हम services के लिए नहीं set off कर सकते थे. Now, इंटीग्रेटेड है सब कुछ. नो सेनवेट आफ्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग स्टेज. सेनवेट क्रेडिट सिर्फ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग स्टेज तक मिलता था, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लेवल तक नहीं जाता था. ऐसा जीएसटी में नहीं है. नॉन इंक्लूजन ऑफ सेवरल लोकल लेवीज इन स्टेट वैट. स्टेट वैट में कुछ लोकल टैक्स नहीं थे. कौन कौन से? लग्जरी टैक्स एंड एंटरटेनमेंट टैक्स. सो इन सारी कमियों को रिमूव करने के लिए क्या आया? गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज टैक्स इन इंडिया. नाउ व्हाट इज जीएसटी? ओह माय गॉड, क्या क्वेश्चन है, यही नहीं पता. एग्जाम में बहुत प्रॉब्लम होने वाली है फ्रेंड्स. व्हाट इज जीएसटी? सी, जीएसटी इज अ वैल्यू एडेड लेवीड ऑन विच? सर्विस टैक्स. तो सर्विस पे लगता था. ओके ओके. वैट मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स पे लगता था. ओ, एक्साइज तो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में था. अब क्या होगा, जीएसटी किस पे लगेगा? लेट्स सी. एंड रिमेंबर, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट बट इम्पॉर्टेंट. GST is a value-added tax levied on manufacture, sale, consumption of which? Manufacture, sale and consumption of which? Of goods and services. GST provide continuous chain of tax credit from the producer point of view, service provider's point of view, up to retailers or consumers level. प्रोड्यूसर के लेवल से होते हुए सर्विस प्रोवाइडर के लेवल से होते हुए हमें टैक्स क्रेडिट की चेन अब एक्सपैंड हो गई है. हमें रिटेलर और कंज्यूमर लेवल तक टैक्स क्रेडिट मिलेगा. दस हम ये कह सकते हैं कि अब हम सप्लाई चेन की हर स्टेज पे सिर्फ जो वैल्यू एडिशन होगा उस पे टैक्स देंगे. वाओ, दैट्स ग्रेट. अ बिग एडवांटेज ऑफ जीएसटी. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स. आई एम सीएस दिव्या वाजपेयी, author of the book Tax Laws and Practice from CS Notes Home, and I am also a practicing company secretary partner at Lextel LLP. Stay tuned, stay connected. I will give you all amendments. I will totally help you. You just keep yourself motivated and do best for your examination. All the best friends. Thank you.